finger to the world. Fuck your ribbons and your pearls. Cause I'm not just a pretty girl, I'm more than just a pretty girl.
Hey guys, it's Mikey and I'm back doing another reaction for you. Today's reaction will consist of me reacting to Kesha's new fucking album, Rainbow. So, the first song on her album is called Bastards. Just from the title, you know what it's going to be about. Seems proper slow for her. Really, really slow.
Don't let the bastards get you down.
Wait a minute, wait. Did Kesha just say bastards? Like, Kesha, what the fuck are you doing? Like, let me rewind this bit, please. Come on, listen to this.
Don't let the bastards get you down.
Yeah. Sick. So, number two on the album is called Let Them Talk. Oh my god. Wait a minute, right. Do you think it reminds you of, like, say, Disney programs like Sweet Love, Zack and Cody? Do you know what the theme tune that reminds me of that? Have a listen. I don't know if you think that, but I do. It actually reminds me of like Disney Channel. Okay, I actually like this one now. So, the next song on the list, number three, is Woman. You know by my reaction that I love this one. I absolutely love this. It is amazing. I've seen this. She's like, nah mate, the boys could not buy you a lot. She's like, fuck off. One. Oh my god, it's gonna kick it down. This, listen to this.
I'm a motherfucking woman.
Love it. Let's rewind that, yeah?
I'm a motherfucking woman.
Yes. Love it. It's gonna kick in there, you're there. Can we all appreciate how good that song is? So, the fourth song on the album is called Him.
You want to sing, this is a hymn for the hymnless kids with no religion. Yeah, we keep on singing, yeah, we keep on singing. Flying down the highway.
This is so different, I actually love it. I know, I keep saying that I love every song, but I actually do.
Sorry if you're starstruck, blame it on the stardust. I know that I'm perfect, struck, blame it on the stardust.
Oh, I would love that. That is, oh, fucking hell. That is amazing.
This is a heaven for the homeless kids with no religion. Yeah, we keep on sinning. Yeah, we keep on singing. Flying down the highway. Yeah, we do it our way. High is out of space. We don't hear with the lies. Blame it on the stardust. I know that I'm perfect, even though I'm fucked up.
Oh, I love it. Can we appreciate that one as well? Because that was fucking amazing. Everybody knows what song is next on the album. Number five is the best song which she's done so far, Praying. I actually love this song. It makes me sad every time, but it's an amazing song. This is, go on, Kesha. Belt it, babe. Yes. Oh my god, I love that. Yeah, Kesha, come on. Oh my god. Go on.
I had to learn how to fight for myself.
up, you found your peace. So, number six on the album is Learn to Let Go. To be honest with you, I didn't like this when it first came out. I first listened to it and I was like, I don't think I like it. But then when it kicked in, I actually started to like it. And then now, I absolutely love it, as you can tell. I love when the chorus kicks in. I love this part, oh my god. I love it. I love it. I love this. She's proper like getting feisty now, and I love it. Go on, babe. Fucking sing it. Yes, babe, we've been through hell or not. We love you. I love it. She's gonna hit. She's gonna kill it now. She's gonna hit it all right. And I can see it coming right now. One minute. Shit's gotta be paused. Let me rewind this. What the fuck? Oh my god. That high note was pretty fucking good. Fuck me, I'm gonna have to turn this up, mate. I love it! So, the next one, number 7, is Finding You. Oh, Kesha, babe. Killing it. I love this. This is probably one of my favourite songs on the album. I love it. Number 8 on the album is Rainbow, hence why I'm wearing this lovely tie-dye fucking top right now as well. Found a rainbow, I love it. Rainbow, baby, so meaningful, this one. Love for everyone. It's scary, such a meaningful tune. So nice. I actually love how she sang it on her own and then literally just like, I think it was like an orchestra, I can't fucking say it, but like, do you know people with the instruments all come in and sang with her? That is fucking amazing. Let's listen again. Listen along. Sing along herself and then now. See, how nice is that? That is so fucking nice. That song is like one of my favourites because it's so meaningful and the lyrics are so touching and meaningful. Whether you're gay or lesbian or bisexual or whatever, or straight, like, you will be able to take something from that song. So, number 9 on the list is Hunt You Down. Let's have a listen. I'm not really interested in like country songs, so I'm not sure if I'm gonna be a big fan of this one. You know. I need to kick in more. Like, and then I'll probably like it. Okay. This is so country western. So country and western. Let's just pause that there. To be honest with you, I'm going to give you my honest opinion because that's what a reaction is, and I'm reacting to her album. I don't like that one. Like, just because I'm a fan doesn't mean that you have to like every song in an album. Personally, I think she could have done that one better. So, number 10 on the list is Biggie Feet. Ooh. Oh. This reminds me of a song from like Centurions and all that and Mean Girls. Oh. I actually love this one. I didn't think I was going to like this one. Oh my god. I love this. I love this. I wonder what the chorus is going to sound like if it sounds like this. Because it's fucking good. Pause. Like, literally, what the fuck? Girl, I actually love it. So, number 11 on the list on the album is called Boots, and I absolutely adore this fucking song. Like, literally. Does she just say that she's got boys in every country? Girl, wish I had that. Oh my god. Fucking hell, Kesha. You're bringing it back to this fucking album. This is fucking amazing. I'm fucking shook, man. Oh! Oh my fucking god, did you see that? She was like, you don't get this fucking kitty. And then she went, oh my god, I need to listen to that again. Bitch, what are you doing to me?
You can't handle these claws.
Ooh, girl.
You don't
girl.
Get this kitty.
Number 12 is Old Flames. I don't know if I like this. I don't think I like it. Because I can't really say anything good about it because I actually don't like this one. So, number 13 on the album is Godzilla. Love it. Love it. Oh. I actually love this one. Love that song. That's like quite emotional if you listen to it carefully. But yeah, it's really good. Fucking hell, I've got tears in my eyes now. So last but not least, we have a song called Spaceship. Right, I'm just gonna have to pause that there. I actually don't like that one. Like, I just can't get into it. Like, some of the songs, I'm like, yes, Kesha. So, yeah, if I had to say what my five top songs are from her new album, it would have to be, number one is Praying, obviously. Number two would have to be Boots, because Boots is amazing. Number three would have to be Rainbow, because I love Rainbow. Number four would be Godzilla, because that is such a mouse song, but it's so good. And then number five would have to be Learn to Let Go, because that one's just a heartbreaker. So, time for my opinion on Rainbow. So, the question is, what do you think? Do you like Rainbow? Do you dislike Rainbow? What is it like? What do you think about it? she showcases a different voice in every single song, and that's what I love, because it shows us what Kesha can do, and I absolutely love that. Every new album, you will get songs that you don't like, and that's why I don't like three of the songs, but it doesn't mean that the album is crap, because it's not. The album is a good fucking album, and I think it's probably the best one she's done to date. If I had to buy this album, would I pay £10 for it in the UK? Yeah, I would. But obviously, I have Spotify, so I'll get it for free. So, overall, my opinion is, I hope this album gets to number one, and I hope these songs get into the charts, because they are actually so good. And Kesha needs this. Kesha needs to get this album to number one. Well, she doesn't need to, but I think it'll show her how great she is. And even though she's been away from music for like nearly 3 years, 4 years, she can still be the best artist and she can, and she can still get a number fucking one. You know what I mean? Plus, comment in the comments below to let me know what songs were your favourites on the album. And then, yeah. Bye, bitch. Love y'all.